What's up, guys? It's Paul back with another episode on
The School Zone.
So you guys probably heard me mention last week that I had a bit of a cold. Still put out a few videos, but I was feeling really under the weather. I'm pretty much over it now. You might hear just a tiny bit of stuffiness left in my voice, but I've got a lot more energy now, and I'm ready to start making videos this week. Being sick just, man, it sucks. Just drains your energy. It's horrible. Glad I only have to go through it once every year or two. But yeah. So thanks for putting up with that. I appreciate it. And we are good to go now. So, if you saw my last episode, we went after the luck bobblehead. Ran into a pretty funny side quest, too. Saved a kid in a fridge, so you'll have to check out that episode. It's a lot of fun. In that episode, I mentioned that we were going to tackle the next bobblehead, which is in this ship that's right behind me, the Agility Bobblehead. So, as a matter of fact, I can show it to you right here. Through my recon scope, you can see it right in the crosshairs. That little thing that's sticking up is a vault boy doing a handstand. But we got to go through this whole ship to get it. So before we do that, though, I looked over the perk chart and I found a couple more perks that I can easily take. So let's jump on that real quick. Okay. So I completely overlooked our wonderful sneak perk right here, which I could pick up the level before last. So I'm definitely going to do that. And then I haven't had too much trouble with this bloody mess. It's not like it was in Fallout 3 where it would just scatter parts everywhere. The bloody mess ends up being, you know, fairly manageable with chunks that you could still find even if it's in tall grass. So this one didn't turn out to be too bad, and therefore I will definitely take the plus 10% damage in combat. Perfect. And then we can't take it again anyway until 31st level. So what I'm going to do for my next perk, which we will probably get on this mission, is I want to start taking this penetrator perk. This looks fascinating, but we need a 9 perception. And currently we have a 6 perception without the clothing. And I've already picked up the perception bobblehead back in Concord. So I will start adding points to perception, which is not a bad place to put the perk points anyway, because it's going to increase VAT's accuracy. So we'll add our next 3 points to perception and then eventually pick up penetrator, and that's going to be pretty cool, actually, hitting people through cover in VATs. All right, and then the last thing I want to do is down some of this squirrel stew to boost our XP just a fraction. Okay, so let's start making our way. And by the way, that is where the luck bobblehead is found. Oh, and let me show you on the map where we are real quick. All right, and this is Spectacle Island. So yeah, this is the place that we crossed over to get to the luck bobblehead right here. And here is where we are headed right now. Okay. Whoa, is that a mire lurk? Oh, it is. Jeez. He's already damaged. And he just flew all over the place, didn't he?
Don't leave anything behind that might be useful.
You got that right, Kate. So time to hit the deliverer. Let's make our way around. So this is the bottom of the wreck. I think you gotta go out and around. Get back in the other side. Here we go. Okay. Let's keep moving. Oh. There's a Mirelurk hunter. Let's take out his legs.
Oh my god, look at that.
Nice. Cool. Alright. Let's just keep following this little path here. Okay, maybe not. Let's check this out real quick. I see a suitcase. Alright, just a little minor loot, no problem. They're dead. Well, that was convenient. Two dead glowing Mirelurks. Alright. Okay, so this is one end of the ship. Let's head up here. Oop, I see a turret. Let's take that. Well, can't unlock that. That's all right. It's probably to take out the turrets, which we can just do right here. Awesome. That's crazy. Nice. Oh, and it the Grim Reaper sprint kicked in too. That rocks. Ooh. You know what? I'm switching weapons. There we go. See what a difference that makes. Did it again. God, I love it. Okay. Well, let's go ahead and level up real quick. Might as well. Okay. So we are adding that point to perception. Like I mentioned a moment ago. All right, now our vats should be... Actually, you know what? Let me show you. Here we go. That is fantastic. 9 and 9. Gotta love it. Well, let's continue on. Oh, we can see another turret all the way down there. I'm glad I came up here, actually. One shot. Oh, I see another turret behind them. I bet I can reach it. Fantastic. Oh, and there's a raider. Yep, let's go for it. Why not? Okay, we'll just take them all out from up here. This is how you do a stealth play. Okay, I guess eventually you gotta go in. I'm seeing someone in my sights. There we go. Oh, he ducked. Okay, so I'm gonna abort that.
You hear that?
Yep, you step out, you die. Nice. Okay, so you know what I'm gonna do? Oh, whoa, I saw a guy. Alright, here's what I'm gonna do for the fun of it. Just cuz, you know, just to show you guys stuff that's available to you. I made these... Where is it? Yep, these berry mentats that highlight living targets. So I've never used them before, to be honest. Actually, it's going to boost our intelligence, which is going to kind of bum our idiot savant out. But I want to see what this highlights living targets is all about. So I don't know. I don't know if it's going to work, but let's give it a try, you know? Why not? Oh, I've become addicted. That's terrible. Okay. So, actually, let's quick save. Let's see what that did to our regular stats, actually. Oh, it didn't do anything to our stats, except boost our intelligence. Huh, interesting. All right, well, let's jump down and see what that does. Open. Oh, I see. I saw just a glimpse of it. There it is. Oh, that's pretty cool. That is pretty cool. I like it. I know where you are now, buddy. I know where you are now. It's great. Okay, I think that was worth taking. Oh, that's Kate. All right. Scared me there for a second, Kate.
Gotta be something of value on them.
You know what? I think I can shoot these things. You gotta hit it right in the light. There we go. Okay, no more spotlight. Thank you very much. Oh, I see him. There he is. Boom! Sneak attack! Okay. Oh, and there's another one right there. That is pretty cool. Oh, you're gonna try to rush us? I don't think so. Oh my god, this stealth build is insane. Alright, I'm gonna have to put out a little video showing you guys all of the all of the ramifications of this build. Oh, there you go. Oh, it's the leader, Rags. Oh, Rags to corpses. That's a birdie. That hidden meter isn't moving anymore, so we might have taken them all out. Look at that! Pretty cool. Tales of a Junktown jerky vendor.
Nice.
I will definitely take that. Well, that was an added bonus. I didn't know it was here. Okay, I can't go that way, so this is so cool. I'm gonna have to start making some more of those things, especially in high-trafficked combat areas. Yeah, but this worked out great because of the all the cover those guys had. I'll take it. All right, let's see what's on Rags. Okay, he didn't have much. Can we disarm these? We can. That's pretty cool. Anything in here? There's a bed that we could actually sleep in if we wanted to. wasn't owned. What are you doing over there, Kate? You stuck? Oh, there's a... Perfect. No lights on me. You know what? I'm gonna take these just for the settlement that I eventually build. Be kind of fun to have a little workout room there. I'm still deciding on what settlement I want to take on. I think I might have found one, actually. There's one of them that has a cat. So if I can have a settlement with a pet cat, you know I'm gonna do that. All right, well, let's see what's down here before we head upstairs. Oh, a stealth boy. Nice. I have yet to use one of those. There hasn't been a real crazy reason to do that, because our stealth build as it is just nuts. Can't get in there. Oh, a mini nuke. We'll take that too. Okay, so we are upstairs and we are just about ready to find that agility bobblehead, which is right here. Look at that. Perfect. All right, well, let's grab it and be on our way.
Hell yeah.
Oh man, that is fantastic. Well, let's take a quick look at the stats now. Agility 10 at 25th level. Gotta love it. Well, it's 10 because of the military fatigues, but 8 is not bad. All right, so our VATs just went up even more. Okay. All right, guys. Well, you know, you could fast travel out of here. You could take this boat down if you really wanted to descend and do some more exploring around the area. But yeah, I think I'm pretty much just going to fast travel back to base. But that is how you get your hands on the Agility Bobblehead. So hope this helped you guys out. Hope you had fun. I made quick work of the place. To be honest, I thought it'd be a bit more of a challenge. But this stealth build is just amazing. So I think the next video I put out is going to show you guys how to construct a character like this. All the perks that I went through, especially in my second playthrough after the glitch. And then after that, we'll move on to some more elements of the stealth build, like getting some covert operations manuals and the sneak bobblehead, things like that. So I hope you guys are having fun. I'm having a blast. Make sure that you subscribe if you aren't already. Hit that like button, share it around, and we'll see you next time on the Skooled Zone. Peace out.